right? So this is what I tried. I always end with this story. This is what I tried to create with our team. So here it is, this Picasso painting. I have no clue what he meant by this painting, right? I don't want to know if there's any art experts out there, because I have my interpretation of it, right? And my connection to this painting is based on when I was 18 years old. My dad died. I was a freshman in college. A month later, our house was burning down, right? So we have six kids in my family, one of which is presenting tomorrow, six siblings in my family. And this plumber was soldering a pipe, and it caught the insulation. The house goes up. Now, what I do at this point is I go run down, turn on the water again, grab the garden hose. I run up to the bathroom. I'm going to battle this fire, right? So I'm in the bathroom with a garden hose, 18 years old. The fire department's been called, right? They come in a few minutes later. They come marching up there. And I'm like, I got the bathroom covered. Why don't you guys get the rest of, you know? And the guy's like, you need to leave right now. I'm like, no, I'm not leaving. He goes, well, I'm going to have to physically carry you out if you don't leave. So leave now. I'm like, okay, I don't want that image. So I had this moment where this is great, right? How many people have been asked the question, what are you going to grab on your way out if your house is burning down? I've been lucky enough to get to make that decision live, right? So I go and grab this book my dad gave me. That's what I grab, right? And we had just lost them a month before. That's what I'm going to grab, right? I'm going to grab this book, not pictures, not whatever. I grab a book, right? So anyway, house gets destroyed. We end up staying in the basement of the house, even though it's declared uninhabitable. We're like, we're not leaving. We are not leaving. So they build the house up all summer. I'm about to go back to college now. And we had this print. It was one of the things that survived the fire. So they come up and they put the print on the wall because things are done now. The drywall's done, and they're replacing the print. And I took a look at this picture the day before I went back to school, and I had a moment, right? I thought, that guy is not holding up the guitar. That's what I realized, right? The guitar is holding him up, right? That's what's happening in that photo, right? It's the brightest part of the picture, of the painting, right, is the guitar. Everything else is blue and grays, and anything that's remotely bright is this guitar, and it's holding the old man up. And I said, that's it, right? My parents never taught me to fight a fire, right? They created a home. And therefore, I was willing to do anything for it at that moment. And so if you want your athletes to feel like that, at the end of a race, going into a race you have no business winning or doing well in, create that guitar. It does not happen by telling them to be better. It does not happen by telling them to fight the fire. It happens by surrounding them with reason to fight, by empowering them, by letting them choose the struggle. I chose the struggle that day. I would have gone down with that house, right? It's a no-brainer, right? Let them get in a position where they have that guitar present. Everything else will come into place.